Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1491, Random Drug Testing. This is a cool question. Sent in a small company of 26 employees, and every month they want to randomly select two of those employees to be drug tested, and they want to use Excel to do that. And they said, well, right now we have 26, but we might have more or less employees in the future, so we want to be able to have this grow. So, let's see. Took the whole spreadsheet and changed it to be one certain color, took the range where they're going to put the employee names, and did no fill there, so that way they know where they're allowed to enter those values. Then, to the left, over here in column A, and I made it a real faint gray, so that way no one would be changing it. I put a nice little formula that says, well, here, let's look at it up here. We're using just equal rand, open parenthesis, close parenthesis. That gives us a random decimal between 0 and 1. But then I said, hey, if B2 is blank, if that employee, if there's no employee to the right of me, then use a really large number. And in this case, 2 is a huge number because it's larger than rand will ever give us. I want to make sure that those blank cells never show up in the next part. All right, so every time we press F9 out there on the left-hand side, we're getting a new set of random numbers. Down here where there's no employees, where there might be future employees, we're getting just the number 2 all the time. All right, now, here's what I'm doing. Put the three numbers, 1, 2, 3. I know they asked for 2. I want to show you how it works for 3, though. And then I ask for the small of $2, $101, that whole list of employees, comma D4. So the small of that range, comma 1, gives me the smallest value. That's the same as min. No arguments there. But small is really good because now it'll give me the second smallest value and the third smallest value and so on. Well, in this case, I'm only going for 3. Now that I know these numbers, I'm going to use VLOOKUP to go figure out which employee is associated with that number. And that might just be me being superstitious, but I made sure that all this flows left to right. That way, Excel calculates the random numbers over in A first, then it calculates the small here, and before it has a chance to go back and recalculate the random numbers in A, it does the VLOOKUP. So I'm going left to right. So VLOOKUP of that small number, over here in A2 to B102, I want the second column, and I, of course, want an exact match. So every time I press F9, we're getting a new set of employees. When you open the file, it's going to recalculate. So, of course, just as soon as you open the file, you're going to have some random set. Every single one is random. Just come up with a policy that says, we're going to open the file, we're going to press F9 6 times, and whoever's up there then at that point are the people. So open it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you're good to go. Great story from the Board of Elections down in the big city south of me. One time, there was a big argument. They set up a spreadsheet like this, and I don't remember, the Democrats wanted them to press F9 6 times, and the Republicans wanted to press it 9 times. And I said, look, it doesn't matter. It's random every single time. But let's just come up with some nice little policy, and every month we press it N times, and you're good to go. Now, in real life, I have extra columns here that we don't need. I'm going to go to the next sheet where I actually combine everything all into one big formula. VLOOKUP, here's the small of A2. Rather than type the number 1, I use the row of A1. That will change to the number 2 in the next row, and then the VLOOKUP. So it all just becomes one nice little formula. They press F9, and they get a new person. Abby leaves. Don't delete her row. Just press delete to delete that cell, and now Abby will never be chosen. New person comes on board. Well, you could put them where Abby was, new guy, or you could put them down here at the bottom, new gal. All right. And see, now they're eligible to be selected. So we'll press F9, and eventually, new guy showed up there, new gal shows up there, so they become part of the group to be selected every time. So interesting little workbook. If you need to do this, just shoot me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. I'll send you the workbook, and you can use this. It works from anywhere from one employee up to 100 employees, and of course it would be easy to customize it for more just by changing that VLOOKUP. So interesting little use for Excel there. Combine a couple of different functions, rand, small, and VLOOKUP. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.